Nam-June has a younger sister named Kim Jong-min. He once said in a broadcast...
Wait a minute. Hold on. Now, Kim, you know you're my guy, right? You know you're my guy, right? But, your sister single, bro? What is up, guys? It's Brislight back at it again with another video on my Snapchat. I read everything. Even if you send me a message, I read it. If you send me a video, I look at the video. If you send me a pic, I look at the pic. Shout out to all you guys. I try to respond as much as I can, but then it's just so many, so I have to just, you know, look at it, you know, say what's up, blah, blah, blah. And then I'm on my Snapchat, on my story, I might go ahead and just, you know, say what's up to everybody and thank you and everything like that. Or if it's a, like one, y'all know what I'm getting at. Yes, let's get into this RM video, man. I'm super, super excited. Y'all already know. People who've been following me know this is my guy right here. This is my guy. Anyway, man, let's get into this video. Let's get it. Let's go.
Hello, everybody. Before we get into Rap Monster's story, let's all just take a moment to discuss BTS's new album and how much it makes me want to die. Holy f***. If you haven't listened to it yet, then holy Jesus, go listen to Mic Drop and Best of Me right now.
I'm not even looking at the video. What am I doing?
Now let's begin.
This song is so dope.
Monster joined Big Hit. He was an underground rapper in his hometown Ilsan and went by the name Ranj Randa.
What?
His parents really did want him to have a so-called normal life and go to school and get a job. So he used to lie to his mom and
I wonder how many of y'all knew that. That was his name.
Really, he was going to Hongdae to rap. SMH. Sneaky boy.
While he was performing underground, Unstoppable's Sleepy introduced Rap Monster to his good friend who also happened to be the owner of Big Hit's managing agency. He was encouraged to try out for Big Hit's talent audition in 2010 and thankfully passed, making himself the first and only member of the group today who was in the original BTS lineup. Many of the originals either left to join other groups or decided to remain as a producer.
What?
For example, Supreme Boy.
I never knew this. What? Look at that crowd. Sugar, J-Hope, I never knew this. That's crazy. Yeah. What else? Huh? Huh? Oh my God! What? Who? He left? He's nice! I'm sorry, hold on. Hold on. Some of y'all told me I was gonna go crazy watching his version. I don't know what it is, guys. Like, don't get me wrong. I love the dancing. I love the singing. But the flow, I don't know what it is about Korean Korean bars, Korean flows, K-rap bars, K-rap flow, the way they just rap, for me, it's like, does something to my ears. It's crazy. Oh my, and look how, the energy, you know what I mean? Like, the singing makes me feel the type of way, it puts me in a mood, depending on what we're trying to do, it makes me want to dance, makes me sad, you know what I mean? Makes me, you know, reminisce, nostalgic and stuff like that. But when it comes to the bars, to the rapping, to the flow, like, that's just, I just get an energy, a rush. That is, I'm trying to tell y'all, man, I'm into this K-rap thing. That's what it is. It's the rapping part of it. Then I'm going to say it's the dancing. Then we're going to go into the singing. And I would say we're going to do it like that. Not that any of them don't matter. All of them matter the most. But these bars? Now y'all know why RM is my bias, man. But J-Hope, though. Huh. Huh. What else? Huh? Huh?
Rap Monster has been at BTS since the beginning. Once BTS debuted, Rap Monster received a lot of criticism for going from an underground rapper to a K-pop idol.
Wow. It's not hip hop. What does idol mean? I want to go home. Hey, don't come for my guy. Hey, RM, you got shooters in Compton. About clothes. Rap album and hip-hop.
Just saying.
Yo, they is really going in. Wait, hold on. What's going on? Oh, did I go back too far? Hold on. Hold on, I might have to pause this. Hold on. Since I understand hip hop culture, it's like being gay. I understand that too. Truthfully, I understand both sides. Hey, look, man. I'm tired of y'all getting on me about Suga and me calling him Sasuke, the Sasuke of the group. Until we get to his introduction, whatever, I'm going to say he's Sasuke of the group, man. Y'all keep trying to tell me he's fun and he's loving and all this kind of stuff. But in all these clips, in every single one of these clips, I even seen something in my recommends that saying that everybody is scared of Suga. Suga is that, and I'm not saying it like he's the Sasuke of the group. Like Sasuke was dope to me. You know what I mean? I'm just saying Sasuke was the, you know, in the cut, leave me alone. I'm the emo. Let me do my thing. You feel me? But if you got problems, I'm gonna show you how intelligent and how skilled I am at this ninjutsu. You know what I'm saying? And that's all I'm saying. Suga got the heat. You feel me? Like that's the shooter in the BTS right now. That's the one you don't mess with. I'm just trying to let y'all know. That's it. Got it. All right. That's it. You're going to be mean to my cute little buddy now. Okay, well then I'm gonna pounce. Why did they use the word pounce? Like pounce is not a, I mean, you know, I'm gonna jump on you, not pounce. Even though they mean the same thing, I know, but pounce is just like a softer word. Let's tussle, bud. Come on, let's go right here, right now. Come on, let's go. I wish they used bigger text on this part. Like, camera's moving and I gotta like really strain my eyes.
So he worked really hard to prove his haters wrong and show them that he was still a bona rapper no matter what title he was given.
I will say this though. Hip hop, or let me not even say hip hop, rap. When you're like an underground rapper, you know what I mean? And that's when I first came into this. You guys were like, why are you always so competitive? Why are you so aggressive? Like, why? You know what I mean? Why do you want to make them? Why are you comparing them? Stuff like, that's how rap is. That's how hip hop is. And I feel like maybe the other people in BTS don't know how it is, but I think Rap Monster, I'm just saying that because of nostalgia when I first got into this. But yes, RM knows that. I feel he's like, he probably already knew what the dude was talking about, where he's coming from. You know what I mean? He knew that, hey man, look, okay, I understand. I was a rapper, you know what I mean? And now I'm doing this K-pop stuff, but at the same time, I just want to merge the two and I just want to be me. That's why, and was it Do You or Joke? Wow, a lot of that's connecting. And Do You or Joke, he did say something like, he said, I'm not R&B, I'm not rap, he was just naming, like, I'm not nothing. Forget it, I rap, but I'm everything, you know what I'm saying? And wow, that's crazy, I gotta go back to that. I really gotta go back to that. Now it's coming together. We should put it all out there.
Now for some facts, of course. Mm-hmm. Rap Monster's real name is Kim Namjoon and he was born on the 12th of September 1994.
12 September.
So LMAO, he's a Virgo. Namjoon has a younger sister named Kim Jong-min. He once said in a broadcast...
Wait a minute. Hold on. Now, Kim, you know you my guy, right? You know you my guy, right? But, your sister single, bro? Hey, just a question. Just a question. You know, just wanted to know. No biggie, hey. Go back to making your pie. What would you, pie? Oh, just a question, bruh. Hey, put the knife down. RM, put the knife down. Don't take that sugar / cigarette out your mouth. Keep it in your mouth and continue with your pie. I don't know why you're eating pie right now, but hey, man, just a question.
Kim Jong-min, he once said in a broadcast on the V app that he used to hate her all the time because she wouldn't let him use the computer for too long. LMAO.
That's just like some sibling stuff.
Never forget. His roles in the group are main rapper and leader. He takes on both roles very well and helps rapper BTS and be the great team that they are today.
Energy. And that camera is lit. Where is that at?
All right, here we go. Let's talk about sexy brain Mon Namjoon. Namjoon has an IQ of
148.
Wow.
Wow. Ramon already knows the answer.
아까 확실하지 않네요.
Look, he's breaking it down. Where's Jimin? Okay. Intellectual man.
He's shown his knowledge skills in many problematic episodes.
뜨잖아요.
맞아요.
이거를 세모로 보면 비빔밥이죠. 네.
야 대단. Oh my god.
이걸 이렇게 90도로
이렇게 이렇게.
그러네.
비빔밥.
And in this one, Running Man clip where they talked about it for like 2 minutes, but it still counts. Just know that this man is smart as.
I believe it, man.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
He's known for breaking things, and always tells the story of how he bought a pair of sunglasses and broke them in the same day. This earned him the nickname, God of Destruction.
God of
Destruction.
What is he about to break? I really want to know. Is it a cup? Hey, I kind of want some Korean barbecue. I'm gonna have to run that this weekend. Hey man, no cook. Look kind of gray, man. What's up? Who's cooking that?
I'll tell you a story. I bought this really good sunglasses in Los Angeles, and I tried to wear it. And
wow.
Okay, so I never wear it. I just wasted my.
Wait, what? Like in you put them on your face and they exploded? Mission Impossible? Destroying ability.
Namjoon is fluent in English, and when they won their BBMA's award, he gave their acceptance speech in English, and he just never forgets to include us international fans in Just Oof My Heart.
Let's fly with our beautiful wings in 2017 as well. BTS love armies as always. Thank you very much.
Shout out, man.
Just a random one, but Nam June has dimples and they're so cute. And like, hell yes, baby. Show off that.
When I got into this, man, you guys are posting so many arm dimples.
Nam June has this weird obsession with Converse and thinks it's such a turn on when girls wear red Converse. This
Converse
wrote a song about it. LMAO, not even gonna lie.
Really?
I bought my red Converse because of this.
Wow. That is my favorite hairstyle, alright, man. The pink hair with the split in the middle, that's dope.
In one interview, Jimin called Nam June out and basically exposed him for putting viruses on the computer for downloading porn. He has this cute thing that he does on their Twitter account, where he posts his outfits of the day and tags it as Kim Daily. It just lets us see his sense of style. And let me tell you,
dang,
sometimes it sure is interesting.
Photographer now goals right there. You know that's the homie doing all that.
He has so many f***ing plushies in his room like Jesus. He looks all tough, but really this boy is just a little cutie.
Yeah, thumbs up. Yeah,
what is he wearing? Lego.
Nam June is good friends with GOT7's Jackson. Or at least Jackson really.
Yeah. You guys want me to react to some GOT7? I got you. Put down below which GOT7 you want me to react to first.
Onto his relationships with the other members.
Okay.
Jin. Okay, let's begin. This is one of the biggest ships in the fandom, otherwise known as Namjoon. People ship these two together hard, and see them as kind of the mom and dad of the group.
Mm.
Probably one of the least problematic ships out there.
What?
저도 맞냐 물어봐 주세요. 정말 맛있습니다. 형 어디 판다고요?
GS.
25. 이걸 GS에서 판다고? 진짜 맛있다. 말도 안 돼. 저희 당근을 한 줄 하는데 인정입니다. 인정. 맛있네요.
Sugar.
Sugar.
Nam June and Sugar work together often and write a lot of songs together.
Mm.
And honestly have such a like bro relationship. You feel? I'll never forget about the log where Sugar is trying to speak and Nam June is just being such a nuisance in the background and Sugar ends the log so he can beat him up.
I told you! Sugar is that guy! Don't mess with him! I can't wait to watch him. I can't wait to watch Sugar's, man, because y'all getting on my head. I'm trying to tell y'all, he the one. Enjoy my life, Sugar, to life. About to pout. Stop using that word. That word is hilarious. That's what you get. That's what you get. That's what you get, RM. I can't hear what you're saying, RM. I can't hear you. Huh? Huh? Sorry, Ariam, can't hear you. Sugar finna boop that ass. Yeah? Yeah? What else?
J-Hope. Yes, these two. They recently shared a moment together during Bond Voyage Season 2, where Rap Monster revealed that he is envious of how hard-working J-Hope is and that he wishes he had his determination when it comes to writing songs and dancing. They don't share a lot of on-screen moments, but are still very close.
Not that healthy. Man, they got a whole platter.
Jimin. Even though he's a man, he still finds Jimin extremely sexy. I feel like Namjoon views Jimin as his little kid who he always has to look after, but also finds him extremely adorable. I don't know. They are a rare duo, but a cute one when they share moments. V and Namjoon are roommates, and I think that allows them to be comfortable around each other. Namjoon gives V a lot of confidence and advice and just tries his best to be a leader and guide them in the right direction.
What's the time of the road?
Jungkook. Namjoon described Jungkook as a moody teen overflowing with passion who doesn't like to share his clothes. Jungkook has said countless times that Namjoon inspires him so much, and I think Namjoon appreciates that a lot because it reassures him that he's doing a good job at being the leader, and that's what this precious boy deserves.
Is that a photo shoot?
What?
He's put a mustache on him?
That Kim Namjoon is a hard-working man who puts all his time and effort into writing and producing music for us. And we should always thank him for his hard work. Please don't sleep on this man.
Nah, never.
So much love, oh my god.
What I hope you mean? Alright, we back. Sorry guys, my camera cut. It was recorded for too long, I guess. Let's get it. Hey, you already know what it is. Go follow, go check it out for yourself. Go watch it again over there. Subscribe, all right, guys? Show some support. Man, I love this fan-made stuff, man, and I knew I was going to enjoy this because y'all told me I was going to enjoy this one. And next we got J-Hope after, so y'all already know J-Hope is my second guy. You know what I mean? So if you guys enjoyed this, go ahead and subscribe. This is a series, so we did some videos before. We got some videos to come. And go ahead and hit the like button. Shout out to the Brits gang, love you guys. And what else? Comment down below. Comment. Y'all got to comment. You know what I mean? I already know y'all probably already did before y'all even watched the video. But anyway, I'm going to catch you guys in the next video. Peace. Oh, wait. Hold on. Briz Gang. If you want to be part of the Briz Gang, go ahead and follow my Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat. And that's how we keep each other updated, man. I keep y'all updated. Y'all keep me updated. And that's just how it's going to go. And I'm going to catch you guys in the next video. Peace.